Let's turn your dull text into designer gold. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to transform ordinary titles using alternative glyphs, those hidden gems inside your font that can instantly elevate your design. Then we'll take it too far with some AI-powered animation, only to realize the old-school 3D extrusion still wins. Or maybe not. You'll get to decide. This one is short, sharp, and full of creative detours. So I'm designing a short teaser for a documentary about the Heidelberg disaster, the tragic story of the world's largest airship that burst into flames while landing in New Jersey in 1937, killing 36 people and marking the end of the passenger airship era. Whether you heard about it or not isn't really the point here, but it's a fascinating story of how human ambition and a few fatal mistakes turned a symbol of progress into a fiery catastrophe witnessed around the world. So to illustrate it, I already started to create a very simple composition. Again, this is what I have here. Basically, the ship is dragging the world to disaster because both of them are parented. Now, I want to make the Heidelberg title a little bit more interesting. So to do it, I'll double click on the text and copy it to the clipboard. Now, notice I'm using this font, Memoriam Pro Headline, which I got from Adobe Fonts. So you can sync it as well if you like. And what's special about this one and a few others I'll show you in a moment is that we have some alternative glyphs. So we can actually replace some of the characters, the letters, with something that looks a bit more graphic and interesting. So of course, this is the font that I'll be using, but a few other alternatives you might want to consider is, for example, Become Script also comes with tons of glyph alternatives, as well as Grappa Variable. You can see some of them over here. And this one, Lindsay Signature. And there are plenty of more to explore inside Adobe Fonts, so just have a look at this and sync the one that you like. But now I'm going to switch to Adobe Illustrator and I'll take the text tool, click and paste the one that I've brought from After Effects. And now there are a few ways to work. One of them is to go to the Type menu and then look for the Glyphs panel, which is going to show you all the different alternatives. And of course, you can make them a little bit bigger and select from them. Or another way to work is to enter the text. I'll highlight the H, and you can see that Illustrator and Photoshop, by the way, will show you the alternatives options. Now, for the H, I'm just going to capitalize it, and then I'll select it again. And as you can see, we can get a few other alternatives. So it's always a good idea to open it while you are browsing for different options. So maybe this one, or maybe this one. You can see that every time I'll double click on it, it will basically add the letter. All right, I'm just going to remove the other ones. And here is a pro tip. If you want to pan the screen, hold down the Option Alt on Windows, which is going to temporarily show you a hand tool here inside Illustrator. Otherwise, if you'll just press and hold the space bar, you will add spaces. Okay, so let's try to see what else we can do. Maybe select the D and come up with this one. Maybe select the B as well as G. And here we have a few alternatives, so totally up to you what you want to go with. And I think this is just too elaborated, so I'll return to the D and bring it back to what it was before. Now, over here, you can also park between two characters and then hold down the Alt key option on the Mac and then just tie them together a little bit to make this cursive font look a bit more legible. So something like this, I think, will work. And then we can close the Glyphs panel and we can return back to the text, select the entire thing. So just copy to memory. Let's just do it the traditional way by going to the edit menu and choosing copy. And then I'll bring back After Effects to the front, double click to highlight this and paste this personal customized version that you can only get by visiting either Illustrator or Photoshop. So After Effects can support this, but it can't access those glyphs internally. Maybe this will change in the future. Now, let's try to integrate this title and make it look like it is part of the scene. So first, I think I'm just going to change the color to white. And you know what? I'm actually going to apply a layer style here. So layer styles, drop shadow. I'll open up the drop shadow and I'm going to try and sample something from the scene and then make it a very dark color. So this very dark teal. And then I'll change the size here, I think, to something really big. So it's just going to integrate better into the scene. Now, there is another thing you can do here. I'll open up the blending options of the layer styles, and then I'll open up advanced blending, and I'll take away the fill. So this is going to leave us just with the drop shadow, which I think looks better. We can also reduce the opacity as well as animate it over time. So I'll start with a value of 0 here. And let's go to the middle of this composition and set it to 50%, as well as animate the distance. Set this distance to maybe 40, and then go to the start and set it to 0. So this is going to look something like this, as if the title comes out of the cloud. Now the clouds are not so apparent, so I'm just going to duplicate this cloud chamber, which is going to make this layer a little bit more contrasty due to the fact that I set it to the overlay blending mode. But just to improve it even more, I'll create an adjustment layer, and then I'll go to effects and presets and look for the shadow and highlight effect. I'll double click on it, and I think the default settings actually works quite nice. So let's go to the start, maximize this, and preview to see how this works. Now, quickly, before we continue, a quick heads up. I've just launched a brand new course with School of Motion called After Effects Insider. This course is my love letter to motion designers who actually want to understand what's going on under the hood. It's packed with workflow hacks, hidden features, and production-ready techniques that will make you faster, smarter, and maybe even a little cooler in front of your clients. It's about half a day long, but don't rush it. Take your time, pause often, and let the tips sink in. There's knowledge here you won't find lying around on the internet floor. So check the link below to learn more about School of Motion's All Access, and hopefully I'll see you inside the course. All right, let's get back to those glyphs and title animations. So this version looks pretty good, but you know me, I had to see if AI can make it even better. So I started by copying the better looking glyph version into Photoshop and placing it over a green background. And this is since generating transparency still isn't a thing. Then I dropped an image of the Heidenberg airship for reference because I want to use its materials. And next I exported each layer and brought them into Google AI Studio, where I used Nano Banana to create a version of the text made out of this hot air balloon material. It took a few tries, but I finally got something usable. Then I moved to Firefly Video, fed those two images, one a clean green screen background and the other one with the title, and asked it with my usual typos to make the text inflate from nothing to the final frame. The results surprisingly interesting, and both Firefly and VO3.1 gave me a few solid options, but I wanted something more dramatic. So I also tried Higgsfield AI, which includes additional partner models. And here are some of the best results from that round of experiments. And who said that AI doesn't have a sense of humor? Okay, I think that my favorite was the Firefly version with the clouds, where the text forms organically out of the mist. So let's use that one. I'll switch off the visibility of the original title, and then I'll add this version to the comp, scale it to about 60%, and position it just right. Then I'll apply the key light effect to say goodbye to the green, and adjust the clip black and clip white to clean it up. Finally, I'll change the blending mode of this layer to overlay to integrate it nicely with the rest of the layers here. Now we can maximize the viewer and see how it looks. Nice, I like it. But I'm curious to know, what do you think? Is this version better than the flat one? Now before you decide, here's another variation, this time using the advanced 3D renderer. So in this case, I've extruded the text, added a 3D model of the Zeppelin, and used some environment lighting to cast this long, ominous shadow that hints something bad might happen. So which one works best? Maybe neither. Either way, you know now how to make your titles shine and how to turn a simple word into a work of art using alternative glyphs. Don't forget to check out my After Effects Insider course, and I'll see you in the next one. Safe travels!